All right.
Milk, the perfect food. If you're a baby cow. So today, I'd like to reveal some truths behind the common myth on milk. The consumption of most dairy, especially milk, has been revealed to be detrimental to humans. I have the authority to make this claim because not only am I vegan, but I've done a lot of research to make sure that it's healthy because I'm a total health freak. I'd like to reveal some things that make it into milk besides the actual substance from a cow. Explain how milk doesn't help humans gain nutrients and that the product is harmful to the environment. So, firstly, what's in milk other than milk? Casein is a milk protein, and high casein diets. Certain cancers grow 5 times as fast. It's also used as a polymer, which binds things together, like they make plastic and glue, blah, blah, blah. And it's also a powerful allergen that produces mucus. So that's why a lot of times, like, I don't know if you've heard this, but after you drink milk, like, you kind of feel, like, phlegmy, I guess, you know? So that's all I'm saying. Also, there's whey in milk, and it's the most basic milk protein. And in whey, there are dead blood cells, hormonal residues, stuff like that. And it's in almost all food. Like, if you look on the ingredient list, there's always going to be whey in it, and it's always the last ingredient, which means there's just a little bit of it, but it's still, like, not very good. So some of the things that are in milk, there are 59 active hormones, 52 antibiotics that they give to cows, there's lead from the cow, pests, feces, which accounts for a lot of the bacteria, there's viruses, herbicides, bacteria, pesticides, 500 times the safe amount of level of dioxin, a growth hormone called IGF-1, which is a key factor in the growth and proliferation of breast, prostate, and colon cancers. For every cubic centimeter of milk, there can be 750,000 somatic cells, which is the family of the pet. Milk has high cholesterol levels. For 3 glasses of milk, it's the equivalent of 53 slices of bacon. A lot of times penicillin ends up in milk because it's used to treat a condition that a lot of cows get called mastitis, which is a stress-induced condition because they're constantly artificially inseminated, and so they can constantly be milked. And they're supposed to wait 2 to 3 days after the cow stops taking the penicillin. But a lot of times they also end up in our milk, which means it ends up in our body. And a little fun fact. Milk is always pasteurized. It's a health food kind of thing. But it's only pasteurized for 15 seconds at 162 degrees Fahrenheit to clean water. You're supposed to heat it at 212 degrees Fahrenheit for about 15 minutes. So, it's kind of easy to see that it's not really cleaning things. Now that it's apparent that wet things survive in milk, I'd like to share what it does to your body. The calcium in milk doesn't really do much because in animal protein, our body produces acid, and to neutralize the acid, our body takes calcium from our bones. So, in vegetable-based diets, that doesn't really happen as much. It still happens, but it's less and less. And then, I just want to show you. So there's organic, the the two blood pumps are organic milk. And if you look at the calcium, there's 30%. And the milk industry likes to say, like, oh, to get calcium, you have to use milk, blah, blah, blah. So there's only 30% of the amount you need in a day, and then there's the exact same amount in the soy milk. And the milk industry just likes to change that around. And then also, the Physician Committee for Responsible Medicine has made the new four food groups, which there isn't any dairy in it at all, but in legumes, which are beans, peas, lentils, stuff like that, and vegetables, you get things that they say you need in milk, like vitamin B and calcium. Okay. And in a 2005 review in Pediatrics Journal, it stated that milk consumption does not improve bone integrity in kids. It's also a cause of plethora of diseases in every system of the body, going from cardiovascular diseases to cancer, to vomiting, gastroesophageal reflux, peptic ulcers, colic, type 1 diabetes, Crohn's disease, rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, and then in the British medical journal Lancet, dairy high diets are linked to multiple sclerosis. And then certain cultures, like Eskimos, Bantus, North and South American Indians, and the Asian population, who don't drink any or little amounts of dairy, almost never get MS. Also, dairy herds contain the leukemia virus, according to the Horace Dairyman volume 147, number 4. And then milk is a huge cause of acne. There was a Harvard study of females aged 9 to 15 in 1996 that stated high consumption of milk is associated with high amount of acne in regular and skim milk. And then if they have 3 or more glasses a day, they were 22% chance higher. Now that it's obvious that milk is harmful to the human body, I want to go into depth into what the milk production effect is on the environment. The negative effects, again, along with low warming, deforestation, Amazon rainforest destruction, animal to human diseases, water shortages, grain shortages, oceanic deadlands. The cattle and sheep rearing industry is more globally harming than coal and all auto industries combined. Greenhouse gas emissions, because of meat products and associated land use, the most important cause of climate change. And lastly, some statistics. 1 pound of meat causes 40 pounds of vegetation to be consumed or used. Each dairy cow ingests 330 pounds of feed and water per day, which equates to 270 pounds of feces and urine per day per cow, 2.53 billion pounds of pollution per day. Milk is 400 times more polluting than untreated sewage, so that means 1,000 pounds of milk has the same polluting power of a town of 7,000. So today, I hope I've shown you that milk is unnecessary for human consumption, but also harmful in multiple ways. Whether or not this hits home with humans' health, animal abuse, or concern for the environment, it goes to show that the production of milk is detrimental to us and the world surrounding us, and is far from perfect.